dummies. It's not a very precise score, so this would be on a scale, yeah, on a scale from result-oriented to, it would be very neutral from result-oriented point of view, but it would be quite technical. But then you have another score, which is graphical, and it has very little musical details, so this would be more in the metaphorical area.
And how would the musicians interpret those?
Yes, so then it's the second layer for which I had the biggest questions, because I'm trying to figure out how can you put something which is bidimensional into linear time, and how can you make this tension something creative rather than something restrictive. And while rehearsing yesterday, we had one rehearsal, I discovered that my intention was that there would be two approaches. One approach would be that they don't know it's supposed to be the same piece, so they just use the scores and they improvise with them, or they read the scores. And the second approach would be that they know it's supposed to be the same piece, and then they use the scores, which happened in the second half, what you listened, because it was from 1 to 9, 3, and from back from 9 to 1, the same piece with different. But then I discovered today and yesterday that inside the category of the same piece with different interpretations, you have very many variations. So we took now the most free one, but an extreme would be that you consider that if the last score, if the most technical score is a very precise one, then you have to really play that same technical score with all the scores. But you can also consider that it's more like a Baroque score, and then you have freedom in other parameters. But I want to avoid treating parameters separately, because I think it doesn't work really so much with the holistic intention of the performers. So I'm trying to see how I can develop a language of how to work with the performers, in which I can say, in which I can obtain what I want. So this is still this is still my fight. And then there is also a bigger problem, which is the form and the general organization, because I see for the performers it's very difficult to change intentions and mindsets so often. And it is difficult to have a global building of tension. So my next challenge is to try to test the piece with different variations of this approach of how to play the same piece. To know that it's the same piece, but how much is it supposed to be the same piece when you play it with all the notations? And also to try to see how I can control more for the other approach, how I can control improvisation more, or how I can obtain what I want, but without telling them what I want. So it comes from them. It's a very feminine approach. approach. And yes, and then so I'm stuck at this micro level for now, and then maybe this will give me an idea of how to build a macro level. But this is really the first time that I work with catalogs ever, and that I actually thought that this could be made a piece and a piece. So if you have any suggestions or comments or
I have two. On the one hand, it's maybe a small question of how you dichotomize technical and rhetorical, what these would mean. But maybe a first question is what is the sameness between these pieces? So when you say they're playing the same piece, what is that piece? What's that sameness?
So the same piece is what you heard in the middle, which is version number 9.
The chords sequence.
The Baroque song.
Yes. You want to hear it once?
Do you have to keep that in mind if you play the other 8? You use those chords in the other 8 or not?
Not in the first half. So what you heard now is a combination of the two approaches. Mm-hmm. When I was rehearsed with them yesterday, I didn't tell them anything about what the piece was supposed to be.
Yeah.
And I also tried to rehearse in such a way that I don't comment anything more than what is on the score, so I test how precise this is to what I wanted to obtain.
How can the force then mean the piece behind the piece if they don't know?
Because for me, yes, for me the piece is not really, to be honest, for me the piece is not really this. For me the piece is my intention of what I wanted to obtain.
Yeah.
So,
but then we go back to Mifan's question, what is the piece? I mean, if it's not the chorus, there's it's something else. Something
it's all the versions that you heard. It's an incapacity of taking a decision of in which direction you want to go, actually.
Does that answer your question?
So it's the version zero as it appeared in my head. So if
which
I want
they
this,
don't know.
Yes, which they don't know.
Okay, so it's in your head.
Yes.
And is the intention that they get it out?
The intention, well, it depends on the approach. In the first approach, the intention is that I see how they perceive my sketches.
Yeah.
So it's a fight with translations, actually with notation.
Yeah. But how can they know if they come close to what you have in your mind?
They're not supposed to know.
Oh, they're not supposed to know.
Okay. I want to see how they interpret my sketches.
Okay, a side question. Are they supposed to listen to each other and react on each other?
Yes.
Why are they sitting with the backs to each other?
So they can listen better. Mm. But also there are other, this is also part of a visual layer that I wanted to add, that they're not dependent on signs, that they're as little as possible dependent on signs, that visual signs that you have to make to each other. So then the piece can be played in other
ways. How's it for you? Can you speak about it? How did that feel when you were playing it?
It was really interesting because every time we play this piece, so like 10, even less from yesterday, every time was completely different. So in a way, it's interesting how we change our mind every time we see the same sketch, but every time we play, it's something different. It was really hard at the same time because I was big on myself.
Did you try facing each other or did you always play with
the No, we
once,
yeah, the
What's
very
the
first year.
What's
so
I'm curious, how is that for when you're playing?
We can read them circle better because we suggest that if we are like that.
Yeah.
You can also, we could also do it if we train it, but now it's difficult. We would have this intention to start together, and then we see each other.
Yeah.
But it's true that you will listen more.
Yeah.
It's only really precise. Also. I mean, maybe it's interpretation and improvisation, but it's only precise.
We knew that. We knew some things that we wanted, not to,
yeah,
to make
the sketches they were really short
and end to them. So if there's silence, don't make more in the same page.
Mm-hmm. We change page if we,
so we
all know that there's silence. The next sound will be the next page.
Yeah.
Because once we tried without knowing that, so at some point they were finished and I was still there. Okay.
But would it have been okay for you or not? Should we always everybody on the same page or not?
For now, yes, of course, ideally, they should be together. I would like to explore also that they don't have to be together, but then it has to be an aware decision. It shouldn't be a random. But still, considering we had just one rehearsal, then I prefer that they sacrifice this than other things.
Yeah.
So it's always, still, for me it's another problem. I don't know how to work with performers so well with this, because if it's too rehearsed, I mean, I have to find ways to rehearse without making it too prepared. So this is another set of questions, because there are already, I could see some patterns that were repeated in the materials. So,
could you play that piece? No, probably not, because it's already in your head.
I'm the only person who
cannot
play it.
Yeah.
Let's say. It could be played by non-musicians as well. It could be made into interactive, it could be made into other art forms, but I would be the only person who can play.
Yeah.
Could you read one of the instructions, please, to see what the page has? One of the pages?
Yes, it's not so much. I can, in 2 minutes, I can read everything. So the first one was an audio score, a combination between audio and graphic. So I said listen to the chords and loop, listen to the harmony and loop it. So I played the chords on the piano for them when we first rehearsed. And then this was the graphic score of how to perform. So this is melodic instrument one, in this case the cello, harmonic. I'm unhappy about how on earth they did this, which is harp in this case. It can be any harmonic and melodic instruments. And the thicker line was the voice.
The thing is that then we knew the chords. It's not that we were
yes, but you listen to them,
knowing anything.
But you listened to them and you saw, you didn't see them notated. So
it was something here, but
yes.
We didn't know exactly.
It could also be that I didn't start with this version, so then you could have not known the chords at all, but I decided to start with this, so you're a bit closer to the video. Of course, the order is very important, but I thought of a lot about how to make the order, and I decided to start with this because it was a way of inputting the chords, but without seeing them written.
But did they relate to those chords now as well, to the ones that you played in the rehearsal?
Yes.
Okay.
But of course it's... you have to, if you really want to think of what the precise result would be, then you have to figure out how much they would denaturate in their memory until they play on stage. So you also have to calculate the time from the last rehearsal, and if you have to, and this is what I'm busy with, working with more the psychology of the
yeah, this was the difficult thing, because I didn't have that
yes,
my
yes.
Head.
I have one question. Imagine that there are two musicians, they want to play this song on the other side of the board,
mm-hmm.
and you're not there.
Yes.
How would you present the music to them, or which instruction would you tell them?
I would send them the score, with the including the audio score from the first, and I would send them the instructions of which approach they should do. I made a rehearsal process inside. They would need the coach to hear from the outside, but they don't need me. Because I wanted to make the rehearsal process in such a way that I don't, by how I speak, I don't add up to the score. I just explain if something is unclear, because it's the first time that it is played. Now I know what I should add and what I should take out, but my working with them doesn't change.
Does it mean that then you need probably, there is a need of a fourth person which knows the piece itself?
No.
In the case like you, so that person is not playing, but still...
There is a need of a fourth person who can coach improvisation ensemble,
okay.
and can listen objectively without having any connection to the fact that I'm the composer or that this is the piece. Just to see if the balance is right, to see if there is something which is pulling down the energy or... But yeah. There is a psychological score in which I say you should think about this and then you walk 3 steps and... There are more metaphorical scores, there is a graphic score which is more geometric, there is a graphic score which is more algebraic, there is a score like poppy score with the names of the chords, and but of course you lose something and you win something with each notation, but you cannot count. You can never have it.
And the text you was reading is one of the texts on the
no.
score?
No.
So you're free?
Yeah. Yes. I really liked a lot what they chose to do. And to be very honest, I just asked myself how much actually do I care from inside the score what it is. Because when I was rehearsing precise scores, I was focusing on, okay, so you have to obtain what is on the score. I was always losing something from the performance. So it's always, what I want to learn is the degree of how I can control that I have this balance according to what I wish or somewhere in the area. So that's my emotional and psychologically, the piece, what you heard in the first half of the piece was also my piece. So I mean, it was really what I had in my mind when I started to use these means to make the piece. So they were all.
But was it also the case the very first time you were rehearsed?
No.
Because they said you rehearsed like 8-9 times maybe. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So then it,
yeah.
No, it's not
coming.
We rehearsed it
4 or 5.
4, yeah, yeah.
The
but still,
piece, yeah.
But still.
The whole piece, we had two runs with the whole piece like this, actually. And then we rehearsed each thing separately, more like only for the score.
Would you say the piece has also become their piece instead of your piece? Or did they play your piece?
I say both. I don't think they're mutually exclusive.
Depends on the notation.
Yeah.
I don't think they're mutually exclusive, but each page is also my piece and is also their piece. And I think that even...
But can they play it actually again? Maybe you can only play it one time. Like the way you described.
Yes, but...
The playing back is possible, but playing...
Playing one time?
Because then they already know. It's in the mind.
Yes, it is possible, but I think you have to calculate the time of how much you... I mean, after 2 weeks, it will not matter, I think.
For me, at least, it's... for me, every picture is... okay, I have in mind, and then maybe I do it a little bit better, let's say. But I have kind of fixed idea what I want to do.
Yeah.
So I don't change it. Yes.
But you do listen to the others.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
yeah, that's...
The rule, as I said, was that ideally there should always be different materials. I mean, but what is most important is that you are always prepared to react. So she asked if, actually you asked yesterday if you could bring already poems, already written poems. But
mm-hmm.
Then I was not allowed to give a yes or no question in my rules. So the only restriction was that she'll be less able to react to the rest if she has the given text. With the amount of rehearsal we have.
Cornelia, what do you mean with your piece or their piece? What was the model?
Well, they rehearse it, so it becomes part of them. They listen to each other. So like a gestalt, it becomes more than what is there. It's, if you would take out one or two musicians, replace them by
yes,
others,
yes,
you
yes.
would have to do the process again.
No, I would say it's 20% their piece in this one. But I also think that I understood your question in a different way, so when it's about the ownership of the of a graphic score or game piece, for me, the most funny how like piece belongs to the performer as well, and the most game-like piece belongs to the composer as well. So I don't see a problem of ownership.
The order, is it fixed from 1 to 9?
In this case, yes, because otherwise they wouldn't know, I mean, it's just because of practical reasons, otherwise they wouldn't know how to be together and be on the same.
The only way to find out for you is, of course, to do it with 3 other people.
Yes.
And see, and then compare.
But then I would like to go further with them, if it's possible,
yeah.
To see if I go to the really extreme approach of really play the same music with the same dynamics, with the same everything, but to play the 9 pages. So there are various levels that I have to still experiment with.
What changed the last page? Do something completely different?
Yes.
Chorales, Bach, or Chopin, Prelude, or
yes, but all these are very specific for this piece, so I would have to do another catalog.
Can you notice if they ignore the instructions?
I think most of the times yes, but sometimes it's. I think with more experience rehearsing, I would not think about it.
Yeah, for example, now when we went back, I was a bit confused with the page. Mm-hmm. The first 2, the 3, I was a bit confused. Are we already in the end? Or is this
actually me too?
Yeah, I'm.
Well,
yeah, because I thought you were playing something.
Yeah.
It's another page or something.
But you could hear this.
Well, I heard that we were in the end, but I missed one page.
Yes, but you can hear this.
Yeah.
You can hear this in the precise of.
It was 1 page.
Yeah, you were.
I remember.
Yes, back somehow.
because I really didn't know the line.
Yes, but the, I mean, I could really, hear it.
Okay.
I don't know if you mean they ignore the instructions willingly?
Yeah.
Or if they miss?
Or they alter the instructions so they can do something. Yeah, to limit confusion. Because it can be confusing when I look at something like this for the first time. And to make it easier to do something, and simplify it until it's completely different instruction. So, yeah. Yeah, I mean intentionally.